So yeah, good morning. And then this is the babble glabble. I guess I wanted to talk more of class today. Actually, I wanted to talk about classism a little bit. At first, I was like, well, no, it's actually not. I'm thinking, you know, that moment of the commercialization person. You have the commercial, that persona, and you get that facade list, and they are this, and they are that, and these are pretty much, they're small, tiny jurisdiction of terms and conditions. Okay, so you have their terms and conditions on the small little tiny facade, just like a house. So there's your person, and they have their little qualifications of who they are, like their resume. And so what's the deal? Oh my gosh, I want to space out. Case, it's really early in the morning, sorry. But yeah, so I'm talking of that did you really want to be, first of all, accepted to their particular white noise, because it is their white noise cell. You know, it's their cell of white noise. Is that where you want to be in an adjunct to, you know, to have a communication moment? Your white noise meeting my white noise. You know, is that commercial? Yeah. And then I'm like, oh, I don't know. This is an odd topic. It's an odd topic, you know, to look at another person as, what white noise are you selling me? What is your white noise? What is your static? And then I'm like, well, if that's the deal, if we're dealing with a white noise to a white noise, do you matter? Or is it just my sound? Is it just your sound? To you, you know, does any other really matter? You know, does any other really matter? Is this just the zhush? I've got my zhush, you know, I've got my zhush going out. In a way, the zhush of our static becomes our entertainment factor. You know, what's your entertain? What is your entertain? Now, your entertain can be a list of remembrance, I'll say remembrances and reminds of what you've learned in your life. Oh yeah, this has worked for me. This has worked for me. And this has worked for me. And I have to impart this back to you. And so there it is, you know, again and again and again and again. And so that could be somebody's static. I have to give you this exact recipe. That's my static recipe. And that's my entertain. So if your static recipe is an entertain, of I will say rule sets of what you've learned in your life, or what you call the predicted have to, well, then that's your entertainment. That's who you are, and that becomes your personality, doesn't it? Now there's safety there. There's a lot of safety. There is a lot of safety. You've got, like, you know, you have masses and masses and masses of generalizations to support you in a lot of things. You know, just anything. Like, I know I'm going back to the shoes, but that's an interesting topic lately. You know, don't wear certain shoes on a slippery floor, or you'll fall. You know, you can carry the cautionary state with you, and when you carry the cautionary state with you, where are you? Well, you've got general, probably McCarthy, backing you. He's even dead, and you've got even written rule sets backing you up again and again and again in people's minds. Oh yeah, I've even seen it written. So you can even run your life through the rites that way, and what you've seen written, you know, that, what do you call that? That under construction ordinance. You can just carry those as your entertainment. And you know what? You'll just get by. You will absolutely get by and be accepted by other human beings. You will not even have a... You may be like, well, you're kind of a jerk. You're always telling me this. You're always telling me that, you know? And it's just like, maybe I don't want to look at the sign. And yet, you will be accepted because you're carrying the sign. You're carrying the sign that is just there, and it's there, and it's there, and it's there. You're still going to be accepted. You're never going to be the black sheep. You're never going to be that. As much as you could be annoying as all heck, as long as you have that sign. Well, I saw it at the store, you know, you're just saying it again. You know. It's just a generalization, you know, he's got or she's got, you know, they're just dragging the generalization rules with them, you know, just like Santa's sack filled with generalization rules. Yeah, that's an odd one, huh? So that's like a static entertainment that becomes an accepted okay. You know, an accepted okay. I should paint my nails, huh? There's all these shoulds I have to do, right? You know, and if I say should, does that give me an extra up in life already? Yeah, I'm getting like a leniency by somebody this morning, or some other person, another one. Oh, should, yeah. I can say should, and that gives me like, yay, I'm on the bonus club because I said it. And I just wonder, you know, that particular, I wanted to talk about classism and its insipid have to exist in people. It just seems to have to exist, and you know it. You know they use it as a separation state because there's just total... total horrible out there, and you know it. Because there's total horrible out there, it's going to get a bonus state. It's going to get an extra star. And once it gets an extra star, once classism gets an extra star, just to keep yourself away from that group, and I'll call them the Calais group at this moment in time, the Calais group. If you've ever been to Calais, France, it's a pretty nasty, pretty gnarly place you don't ever want to be. Because of, I guess it's like a port state in people's minds. Maybe they get extraordinarily overdone. I'm not really sure what's going on there, but yeah, they do. They end up being extra overdone. And personable. Yeah, extra overdone and extra personable. Yeah. Dun, dun, dun. These are fun, huh? Nails. What morning is it? It's, I don't know, it was 5:30. I woke up at 5:30. I'm thinking about the white noise of well, I don't want to even call it aristocracy. I want to just call it the second class, the first class, the second class. We're just still talking the Titanic, aren't we, in a little bit. Steerage class. you know. And that separation, you know, it's just like, oh my God, no, I'm sorry. You know, that's just it. You know, I have my separation moment, and that's it. I don't talk to you. I have my particular rules, and that's it. It keeps me in my static situation of safe. And in that static situation of safe, I have my little group, and everything is all fine. And you can call it clicky if you want, but I don't even It's actually just a sanctuary. It's a sanctuary of safe and secure. That's all it is. Because it's an inordinately scary world out here. So you can't really blame them. You can't really blame them for running to Ascot again and again and again. You can't blame them for being pretentious. You just cannot blame them. They're in a self-protection state. They're just like little children running to their mommy, you know, under the wing of, there's a big bad guy, you know, he tried to hit me. There's a big bad dude, you know, he said something mean. There's a, and instead of it being a big bad dude, it's more like a mob of, I you can call them the unruly's, you can call them, what are they? I don't even want to say it. It's the person when you get drunk and you get out of control. I don't even want to say that or call it that and go, oh my gosh, and then now, what the heck? They're practically, you know, bonking on the street, and then they are. No, not that. I'm not talking that time frame. I'm not talking that particular unrule. Oh, yay. I know, y'all. I'll let you see my dirty cup. I know, it's so Russia there. I know, they have that cup there on the street. They say, I've never been there. It's kind of interesting. You know, when we talk about classism, the class state, you know, you're thirsty. You're going to drink out of that cup. They have the share situation, you know. That's not really going on. And I wondered the dire, in that moment, I'm like, well, what, think about the dire situation of a person who is, you know, so much dragging in classism with. They would maybe perhaps, you know, just linger with thirst a lot longer and go dehydrated and faint rather than drink out of that cup. You know, I mean, there's a part, and then I'm like, well, wait a minute. Oh my God, that's me. I'm not drinking out of that cup, ever. Do you understand? Not ever. I will walk to the river, and I will scoop the water with my hand, but I am not ever going to drink out of that cup that was shared by hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. So I guess so. So yeah, I guess so. So I'm a snoot. And that doesn't help. It doesn't help anything to be a snoot, does it? It's almost like people just live to kick me off my cloud. She's on a snoot cloud. How can we get her off of it? Yeah. What was the deal? I don't know. I'm a massive mess today. My mind is swirling with. I am having so much fun with the idea. You know, and I just want to play. I just want to have the idea of that expansionism moment. That yes, this is now ordained. This entire neighborhood that I'm in right now has become the opera neighborhood. And we're going to have pianos, and we're gonna have orchestra instruments over there. I need some people playing the flute. I need people over there. Oh, did you know that I used to play? I know, since this is like, you know, let's talk about who you are and what you used to do. I used to play the French horn. And so because I played the French horn, my gosh, what a little, it's a little bastard, isn't it? It's a little bastard instrument that is heavy. And I had to have that little French horn, and oh my gosh, it's a difficult one. It's a difficult one. But can you imagine a world without a French horn? You know, there are people who have never even heard of a French horn. Yeah. And so there, maybe that is like, no, you can never sing like me. No. I played the French horn. Changes everything. Changes everything. Yeah. It's all part of the build, you know, you get a different build in the pipes. I don't know how we could do that, you know, have like the absolute theatrical neighborhood purchase. Everybody, you know, and then that's it. And that, so I'm a limiter and I'm a segregationist. Absolutely. I wanna limit. I don't want the others here. I just don't want them here. I only want artists. I only want to be surrounded by artists. And more artists. And artists again. Yeah. So yeah, I guess so. I guess even then, you know, I'm talking about this, like, what do you call it? This idealistic state that we're able to keep this art swirl, you know, just live in this art swirl and keep it going. I'm like, how can we do this? How can we maintain it? How can we do this? And so I came up with this government, you know, the 20,000 a year. Everybody gets this. We're supplied. We have the per diem, essentially, to get by. And we have the ability to buy and produce, things. So we all are getting towards utopia with my government. And that is the entire point. So we can all be artists, and we cannot just be this limit that seems to exist right now. So, okay, so I try to do this, and then yet I'm just like, what? Slandered into seclusion. Slandered into it. Like, how dare you? We're an economic discovery only pity party that drags people around in the mud and the poor and ignorance. And demands that Calais group, and I don't even want to say the word today. It's in my head, and you know it. You just know it. That's a really harsh pink on me, huh? But you know what? It's a pink that you only kind of see on redheads more. Not many. What do you call them? Yeah, I don't know. It's almost, I don't think it's popular with many of the other ones. So anyway, so I've been on this classist cloud like my whole life. And I can say it's ballet. I can say ballet's put me on a classist cloud. But yet I've met some dancers that are just like raunch. And I'm like, what's the deal? What's with you? You know, what's with your trash mouth all the time? where did you come from? And how did you even get here into my studio? I mean, how dare you even be around me? You know, when I think about, you know, like the state of dance or the state of the theater or the state of arts, our maintenance, we have to maintain it. And we have to maintain it by not letting those type excel and become what do we call it? Stage personas even. I don't even care if you're the greatest dancer on earth. You know, what is it that you're providing? What is it that you're providing? If you're just a reckon of some kind of horrible, what do you call those shows? Those Coronation Street upsets. You know, if that's who you are, I don't know. Just another what do you call it? Yeah, no, you're not helping. And so all of this goes on. No, I don't want this type of person around. I don't want that type of person around. What, you're involved with this? No, you're involved with that. There are limits. I have limits. So, I mean, what, you're out there robbing cars for a living? No. I'm sorry. I don't care if you're beautiful and divine as a dancer. I don't want to hire you. How about that? So yeah, I guess that's part of my static, becomes part of my static. Do I have a group that's following with me on that one? Maybe for a moment. Shh, got a little shush, you know, maybe for a moment. Yeah, I don't really want that guy in the company. That's kind of, you know, a trouble. I don't want her in the company, you know, that one, you know. Oh my God, you know. You know, they have those women. And then I'm like, well, what does that even represent? You know, sometimes that's just a, I don't know, just somebody's bad mouthing, and they get so industrious with their bad mouthing of another human being that they leave that person in that industry, you know. Yeah, so that becomes almost like a chance situation, where you give them no chance. And so in a way, we become the judgy self again. We start judging, you know, as a director or as a member of the human race, you know, you're walking through judging, you know, do I want 1, 2, 3 classes here, Titanic time city going on. You know, do I live in that? Absolutely. You know. And then I wonder my victimization, you know, why am I in this victimization state? You know, simply, merely, purely because I said the wrong words? I said the wrong words, and so I got out of their static. So is that all it was? I said the wrong words and I was removed from their static. So in a way, it's kind of interesting to find myself in my own seclusionary static hold. Yeah, they're loud. They're loud. Sometimes people carry such a loud abundance of white noise gathering with, you know, the white noise. I have this group, I have that group, and you know it. You know it, even just sometimes by what they're saying. You know, you already know they're bringing in so much of that store, so much of that engineering, so much. Yeah. Yeah, that you're just looking at a wall. You're looking at that static wall. And when the static wall tries to, like, bulldoze you, when the static wall tries to steamroll you, then that static wall is a murderer. That static wall is a murderous self. So yay. Rawr. Do you hate that moment? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. Anyway, so it's fun, isn't it, when that happens? But gosh dang it, then it isn't, you know. It's kind of a, why is it necessary? Why do people have to have such a pronouncement of steamroller, of the steamroller static, you know? I have the power of all of these generalizations. I can kill you. You know what I mean? Yeah. Anyway. I tried Verity yesterday. It's going well. I believe Verity is a little bit more my fach, my direction. Yeah, I have a lot of that, and so yay. Gosh dang it. I'm still looking for elastic. I guess they like took it out of the stores, and I'm very interested and intrigued by that. Like when I went to the Target, they don't have anything material. You can't buy sewing, you can't buy anything. You know, women have been sewing for years and years and years, you know, like centuries. Women have been sewing. And I can't find material. I can't find even needles and thread. It's just become like, are you kidding me? What is this damnation to something already produced? I mean, I think it's wrong. I think it's inherently wrong. It's like I was talking about my brain, you know, my brain has been treated a specific way, you know, when I was born into this planet. It's been treated a certain way, and I have been sewing. I have been knitting. I have been doing all of these things in my bloodline. So why did you remove me from it? Yeah, and so the store is devoid of it. It's just a shopping mall with buy it as new. Buy it as new. Anyway, I know. So yay. I know, I didn't really talk enough about this, the static of the self steamrollers and this, what do we call it, the segregationists of class, protectionism. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, it's just something I'm thinking about.